in the last video, Raman Maharshi was talking about the fundamental ignorance, this I, which is basically a thought, but we are infusing our identity with that. And the Raman Maharshi is saying that one should constantly ask oneself, who am I? And that way the mind will become quiet and that ignorance can be removed, right? And Sri Prakasham Pillai is asking now, so how does one can constantly hold on to this thought of who am I, right? I can have a thought, but then that thought doesn't stay longer, right? So how can one hold on to this thought of who am I persistently, right? And the Raman Maharshi replies that when a thought arises in the mind, one should not follow it. It does not matter how many thoughts arises, one should not pursue them, but one should ask, who am I? To whom these thoughts are arising, right? And the answer will be to me. And then one should ask, who am I? And that way the mind will go back to its source and the mind will become quiet, right? So he says repeatedly when one practices this, mind will stop leaving the self and it will become quiet, right? And that way you will have the self-realization. And then he says, whatever one's do, one should do it without this egoity, this sense of I. And that way everything is the nature of the self. Interesting. So one should not pursue the thoughts. Instead of that, one should ask to whom these thoughts are arising. And one should repeatedly do this. So that will become your habit. Okay, so one should not pursue these thoughts that they are arising. It is very difficult to do. And why there are these thoughts? What are these thoughts that are arising? And why? And what exactly they are telling us? Yeah. So basically what we have done is, you know, based on our conditioning, we have created a model inside our head, right? We have created a world inside our head. And these thoughts are telling us, how can I, you know, realize that world in the real life, right? And everybody has done their modeling differently, right? Some people might have a model of, you know, I want to achieve something, I want to be wealthy, and that sort of model. And the person can have a model of, I want to have a family life, I want to have, you know, kids and communities and all that kind of life, right? Another person could have built a different model altogether. You know, I want to... like a terrorist, I want to end certain communities, they are not good or whatever, right? So these are just different models that we have built. And our mind is constantly telling us that what we need to do in order to realize that model, right? And it is, and the way it tells us is there is an I into that, right? I need to do this. And which is basically is we need to do certain action to realize a model, right? And the thing is, The interesting thing about this process that we are into, these creating these thoughts, the thoughts are being generated, then we are acting, and then the new thoughts are generating, then we are acting. Is this process is endless, right? There is no end to it. Once a thought ends, then a new thought will come, a new desire will come, and it will continue, right? It's a circular process, so it will never end, something like that, right? And the Raman Maharshi is saying is, instead of buying into that process, of, you know, building a model and going after it and, you know, trying to realize it, one should ask to whom these things are coming, right? Especially if you're interested in what exactly you are, the self-realization and all that, right? Because this model will continue forever, right? So instead of pursuing these thoughts, because these thoughts are only going to be about that. So instead of pursuing these thoughts, one should ask to whom these thoughts are arising, right? And the answer will be to me. And once that answer comes, you should ask, like, who am I? So you just finished a thought before it blossomed, right? Before it became like action and before it created the external circumstances, and then these circumstances, you know, loop back again, more information to the model, and the new thought came and all that. Instead of going through this whole process, one should ask to whom these thoughts are coming, and you end the thoughts there itself, right? The thought finished there itself, and the mind goes back to the self. And the repeated practice of such will quiet the mind down. So the mind stop creating these thoughts it should be like this, it should be like that. And it's not just the mind is telling, you know, how you can realize your model, whatever the model we have built. But if you are realizing the model, then the mind is becoming more egoistical, more pride, like, look how good, how great I am. If you could not realize the model, then the mind is self-deprecating, depression, suicidalness, and all these things come. So it's just the system that is creating these thoughts. And these thoughts have this I, which is the key ignorance. And the Ramana Maharshi is asking to question that I, so that instead of going through the whole process, mind goes back to the self. And that way you will have the realization of the self, right? And then he says, instead of doing everything with the egoity or I, the sense of I, which is how we are doing everything, right? I need to do this, I need to do that, I need to get this, I need to, you know, avoid that and all these things. So instead of doing everything with this sense of I or egoity, one should not do anything with this sense of egoity. And then whatever you experience, that experience will be the nature of the self. That is interesting, that one should not do anything with this I-ness or this egoity. And then how will one do anything, right? Like, if I don't have a model in my mind, like what exactly I want to do, and go after it, try to do that, then how will I do anything, right? How will things happen? And the Ramana Maharshi is saying, when you don't do anything with this sense of egoity, the nature of self is revealed, right? Then you will realize that everything, you will act according, or you will act in harmony with the nature, like everything else that is acting right now. For example, right, there are things, sun is shining, the rain is raining, you know, and the flowers are growing, the everything is happening. There is an intelligence behind the gravitational force. We didn't create that, right? There's already the intelligence is there in the nature, which is moving all the pieces in the right harmony. So you will also be moved in the right harmony in that way if you stop doing this I thing, right? That's what the Ramana Maharshi is pointing out to, in my understanding. Yeah. So one should do things without the egoity. One should do things without this sense of I, without this sense of building a model that what do I need to be okay, and then try to do that. Instead of that, we should let go of this I and, you know, get established into the self. And then the nature of the self will move you in a way that is more harmonious to the nature.